Where do we run to? What do we do? Why is this country like this? Why are things insecure? Why is nobody saying anything? Like right now, if anybody dies, nobody's going to bait an eyelid. People, what's popping? Kilo Shaila, again a name, eh? Let's go there. Okay, wonderful people, beautiful people. It is your favorite Achalugo, Derek Zell, on the microphone. If you are new to my channel, I am Chiderek Zell, a Nigerian lifestyle vlogger living in Owerri. I'm vlogging from Owerri live and direct. You guys, I know I just did that intro and I was smiling, but there is fire on the mountain. Agwon on Akrika, as my Igbo people will say. There is fire on the mountain and nobody seems to be on the run. You guys, Owerri has been hot. Like from January, it first started with Olu, my hometown. And I was like, okay, it's in Olu, I'm in Owerri. And I need to do a little flashback. When I was leaving Abuja last year, I had different reasons for leaving Abuja. But one of the main reasons I had to leave Abuja was because of the insecurity in this country, so to say. I felt this place is surrounded by the north, is in the north, is surrounded by northern states and all of that, the Boko Haram stuff, all those kind of stuff. So that was one of the reasons I left Abuja. And during NSAS, Abuja was one of the hottest zones. Lagos, Abuja, they were the hottest zones. So I was so scared. And the period when I was rounding up my youth service was that NSAS protest period. So I was so scared, and that was one of the reasons I left Abuja. So it's tearing my heart to pieces that I left Abuja and came to Owerri, because I've always known Owerri as a peaceful state. My secondary school was in the east, and I used to come to Owerri a lot during my secondary school days. And Owerri was damn peaceful, like effing peaceful, very, very peaceful. Olu was like, if peace was a place, Olu was peace itself. My secondary school was in Olu. Olu was peace itself. So it's tearing my heart that in 2021, Olu is now upside down. Owerri is now upside down. 2 days ago or 3 days ago, I was not online because my phone was down. So I was not online. And I put on my phone and I started getting calls. Like different loved ones from different parts calling me that how far I'm in Owerri, what's going on, what's happening, what's popping. Like, hope I'm safe. I heard Owerri is on fire. Government house, house of assembly, all of that. And I was shocked. And so I asked my family, I was like, I heard so things happening in Owerri. My phone has not been on. Yupu's phone is on. What happened? What's going on? And I heard that it's not government house that they burnt, that they burnt the house of the governor, his village, and the house of assembly. Like, everywhere is on fire, that we have to be careful in Owerri and all of that. And yesterday, what we're seeing online, Douglas is on fire, Douglas is on fire, Douglas is on fire. Obviously, I don't live in Douglas, so I didn't hear the gunshots. I didn't know that they were shooting in Douglas. But from people who were around there, people who live around there, I heard that it was actually true, that even places surrounding Douglas, Wedgewell, all those places surrounding Douglas, that they were hearing the gunshots. Like, it was just gunshots, gunshots, gunshots throughout the night. And I'm wondering, what is going on? What is happening? Why is peaceful Owerri turning into a war zone? Why is Owerri more bloody than states that are known for violence and all of that? And if you look, some coppers will be going to camp next month, maybe next week or next 2 weeks, and they're going to post some of them to Imo State, and some of them are going to have to travel through Owerri, even those that are going to other places in the east. Some of them may have to travel through Owerri, and they're going to risk these young ones' lives. Do I need to talk about the people that are living in Owerri, to the business people, people that have to go for their businesses? Imagine someone working in Douglas now. How is that person expected to go to Douglas this morning? Me, yesterday, I was supposed to go to Douglas. I had plans to go to Douglas. I wanted to vlog, and I also wanted to go fix some of my footwears. I mentioned this in one of my vlogs, that I needed to fix my footwears. I wanted to go fix some of my footwears, but my phone was down, so I couldn't go. I was like, ah, my phone is down. And I was like, let me wait until today when my phone is up, so I can go and fix up the shoes and vlog in the process. And all of a sudden, I start to hear Douglas. They were shooting yesterday night. So as it stands like this, I go nowhere. This cloth I just put on is just to make this video. I'm not going to film anything. I'm not even going to step out. I received a call from a loved one this morning. She was calling me. She said she was worried, that she has been calling different people in Owerri, telling them that if they can leave, they should leave. She was now telling me that if I can leave Owerri, if I have any place I can go, I should go for now, because as it's sounding, everywhere is hot, everything is on fire, this one, that one. Like, that call was scary. But in as much as I want to travel and leave Owerri, where am I running to, please? Nigerians in diaspora, or Nigerians living in Nigeria, where am I running to? If the place I'm running to is now outside Nigeria, there's no point running. Honestly, there's no point running, because I can say I'm leaving this Owerri now, I'm running to Port Harcourt. Tomorrow you hear that something has started in Port Harcourt. Or I'll say I'm going to Lagos. Tomorrow you hear that they shot so people in Lagos. I'll say, hey, let me run back to the Abuja I came from. Oh, I have relatives in Abuja. Oh, I still have friends. I still have where I will go and stay in Abuja. Oh, as I'm landing in Abuja, I will hear that they are fighting in Abuja. They say terrorists are coming. They did this one. They did that one. So where am I running to? That is the question. Where do we run to? What do we do? Why is this country like this? Why are things insecure? Why is nobody saying anything? Like right now, if anybody dies, nobody's going to bait an eyelid. Everybody's going to look straight. Everybody's just looking straight. Okay, in this Owerena, apart from this insecurity thing that is going on, if you go out in Owerena, the thing that is raining now is falling poles. Falling poles. In my bus stop alone, we have two, maybe three poles down on the floor. There are wires on the floor. So when I'm going out now, I don't even go through that place. I'll have to corner and walk front a bit and now follow the other side. So I don't have to jump any wire before any voltage or power supply or whatever I'll be running through it. And God forbid, they'll not say something bad about my enemy. You get? There are falling poles all over the place. So many things are going upside down. Like, God blessed this nation. God bless this nation. Is it natural resources? Is it mineral resources? Is it human resources? We are blessed, but things are just going upside down. I need to know why innocent people are being killed. People that go to open their shops are being killed in front of their shops. Students that are going to school are being knocked down. They are being killed. Poles are falling. People are being electrocuted. We're hearing gunshots every time. There was a prison break. We heard that the prison in Owerri was burned down. Up to today, we don't know the people that burned down the prison. We don't know what their aim was. We don't even know what happened to the prisoners. We don't know anything. The other day, I was somewhere and I heard that a woman in Douglas, one of the prisoners that escaped from the prison, ran to her shop. And she was now panicking. She now picked up her phone and went to call police. I heard that the police officer did not come. What we were not saying was that that woman put her life at risk for calling that police officer. Because the security agents, they are scared too now. They are now afraid. They are actually supposed to protect us, but because of the way things are going, they are afraid. Yesterday, I saw it on Channels News that they attacked one police station in Okigwe zone. I don't know whether it's Okigwe South or wherever, but somewhere in Okigwe, they attacked somewhere in Okigwe and they killed 5 police officers. So if you are a police officer and they call you that, something is happening, will you go there to go and salvage the situation? You may be mobbed. You may be beaten. You may be giving jungle justice and that's how your own will go. Like, they have been killing so many of them now. But we don't know the people that are perpetrating this thing. Someone should just tell me, because this thing is making me go gaga. It's making me go crazy. Right now, the only thing I can do is to just, after doing this thing and editing it, even as I'm doing it now, I'm still praying. Almighty God, please safeguard me. Please safeguard everyone I love. Please safeguard all my friends. That is the prayer now in Nigeria. Nobody knows what to do, because if you are running, as long as you are not running to Yankee, you are running in vain. Yes, see Lekki toll gate. If you have been in Lagos before, if you have lived in Lagos before, that Lekki toll gate is like the most peaceful place in Lagos. If there was ever any prophet that came out and said that there will be shooting in Lagos, that they will shoot so many young people dead and all of that, the first place that will come to people's mouths is Mushi, Ajegunle, Surulere, all those hot zones. But look at where it happened. Look at where citizens were massacred. And up to today, we have no accounts. Nobody has come out to say, these are the people that killed these citizens. This was the reason they were killed. This is why this so thing is happening. So there's no point in running anywhere in Nigeria. The only thing we can do now is to pray. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's hope that our God will guide and protect us. Because at this stage, I'm tired. At this stage, I'm fed up. At this stage, I don't know what to do. Let God just help all of us. If I keep on talking, if I keep on saying everything that is happening in Nigeria, this video will be 100 hours long. And I'm still not going to be done. Just pray for everybody who is living in Nigeria now. Pray for God to save us. Pray for God to help us. Our home is supposed to be our safe haven. Our home is supposed to be the place where we will be and we will feel safe to a very, very large extent. But unfortunately, our home is a danger zone for us, and we have to run to other people's homes to be able to be safe. It is a huge tragedy. It is a huge tragedy, but God is going to keep on saving his children. I pray the Almighty God is going to help you. If you are living in Nigeria, may God guide and protect you. If you are living outside Nigeria, may God guide and protect you. May he meet you at the point of your needs. If you have stopped going to work because of all these violent things that are happening, please just stay safe. If you are staying in Owerri, please stay safe. Go out only when necessary. go out only when necessary. Don't go out when it's not necessary. Go out when it's necessary. Maybe you want to go and get the things you will cook or you're going to work. When it's not necessary, any outing, any party, especially night parties. If you ain't nowhere, no go night party. Because you may go for night party and they'll start shooting and there'll be roadblocks everywhere. If they catch you, you end up in cell. You use your money and bail yourself. That's if you even come out alive. Or that's if you even enter inside the cell alive. The stray bullets may hit you. So just stay one place if you're in Obere. This is not the time to be working about. That's all I have to say. Anyways, you guys, I'm going to vlog anytime I'm able to vlog, because obviously I can't go out now, so any vlog I'm going to be doing, it has to be indoors, or if I manage to step out, I'm going to vlog. But you guys should just stay tuned, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not subscribed, pray for Nigerians living in Nigeria, pray for us, we need a prayer, and hopefully I'm going to be seeing you in my next video. For now, bye, kiss kiss, love ya.